When you visit a doctor, you describe your symptoms in words. But the doctor also uses other information to make a diagnosis, like listening to your lungs, feeling your pulse, or looking at your skin. This not only makes it easier for you to communicate, it also gives the doctor more information and a better chance to make a correct diagnosis. Imagine if the only way to send and receive information was through written text. What a pain that would be for you and your doctor. In artificial intelligence, or AI, this idea of working with different types of data is called multimodal AI, since the data types are sometimes called modalities. Multimodal AI simply refers to AI that can input, process, and output multiple forms of data, including text, speech, images, and video. One example is Google's Gemini model. Impressively, Gemini can not only understand your voice, but also respond to real-time video input. And based on the prompt, Gemini can generate verbal responses, music, computer code, images, and more. Another example of multimodal AI is ChatGPT-4, which can understand text, voice, and image prompts. That's an upgrade from the ChatGPT-3 series, which was unimodal and could only work with text. Note that some AI models deal with multiple types of data, but in a different way. For example, the Sora model by OpenAI converts text to video, and the Music FX model by Google converts text to music. Both deal with two types of data, but they're not considered multimodal. You can't currently use a video or images as input in Sora or input audio to Music FX, and so they're called cross-modal models instead. Multimodal AI, on the other hand, is really exciting because its interface makes it easier to input and output information and leads to enhanced abilities. For example, self-driving cars can use cameras, GPS, and even audio to improve their safety and reliability. And just like the human doctor, multimodal AI in healthcare can use clinical notes along with images of X-rays or MRIs to provide better patient care. In fact, a 2022 study in Nature showed that multimodal AI analyzing tabular, time series, text, and image data from over 6,000 patients outperformed unimodal AI in various tasks, including chest pathology diagnoses and length of stay predictions. Multimodal AI also creates new applications. One example is education. By inputting an image of a homework assignment and a spoken question about it, multimodal AI can provide tailored help, explaining why something is wrong or giving hints for the next step. Scientists can also use multimodal AI to help them do research. For example, by performing literature reviews, summarizing large bodies of text in a video or audio format, or organizing data from various plots and tables into one common dataset. What's next for multimodal AI? Just as ChatGPT upgraded from text alone to text, audio, and images, we can expect to see more types of data being supported. Some research and engineering questions need to be solved to make this happen, since dealing with many types of data presents unique challenges. But as more innovations are made, we can expect multimodal AI to have even more modalities, enhanced abilities, and new applications we haven't even thought of yet.